And I really think it's wonderful because it deals with future.
So I think this immersion in an ambiguous space and time, frankly, I think represents Korea very well.
I must say it's fresh, wonderful. All in all, I must say, it's like every year.
Future.
Interface.
I think it's a very hygienic, futuristic vision, which was tried to translate into a film. It's also scary in a way, so because it's so emotional, without any emotion, I guess.
The interface between her and her environment and the rest of the world is technology.
Ethereal.
Technology.
Transcends time and space, and like the idea that art has no boundaries and that it goes beyond art.
I don't know, for some reason it reminded me of everything I associate with Korea, basically. That Korea is a technology friendly society.
The title is that the ways of holding space and flying is... actually, this is the word that is symbolized human desire. Achievement for the impossible things.
The ways of holding space is a very Taoist idea of manipulating space. And the flying, obviously, is the most common desire in any civilizations from ancient times to the present.
It's connected from the Venice to Seoul. It's kind of holding space, another holding space for the time and space. So we try to recover or some overcome or extend these architecture characteristics to represent at the rear side.
You think about what really drives our civilizations to certain directions. So what we were really thinking about was to think time and space as manipulable and changeable rather than fixed. And the way we're showing the media work inside and outside of the building and looking into the past, present and future, it shows the different spectrums of time and space.
Flying autos, and we will see maybe in 100 years there are these devices, automatical big autos that you don't even have to drive.
We're gonna use so much like physical vehicles like cars in the very, very long future. Maybe without tires, maybe they will float in the air.
It would be nice if we weren't so reliant on energy all the time. It will get more efficient and more, I think, environmentally responsible.
Maybe something that is really more close to the human, to the nature. So something that can connect to the nature and could possibly be more ecological.
Even cannot fly, a human cannot fly in the sky, or is a time space and then wormhole and the transportation. That is an impossible thing, but it's always people's desire to dream about it.
Artists who open a view onto the future by exercising what I call radical imagination.
But artists are capable of catching the moments and formulating themselves beyond language in a way, and I think that will help us and give us some guidance for the future.
Only because the earliest aspects of human civilization included art. Art as a spiritual part of life